I had been in the Trackhawk's driver's seat for maybe a minute and just buried my right foot. To brag a little, I've hit 171 miles per hour on the front straight of Big Wall in a Porsche 918 and hit 193 miles per hour on the Bonneville Salt in an AMG GTS. I'm used to big machines doing big things. But none of them tickled my funny bone like this $100,960 Jeep. I haven't laughed about a car like that since, I don't remember. What's it feel like? Well, some of the giggles come from how it launches the opposite of a Hellcat. Perhaps not what you'd expect because the two vehicles sport the same engines, same power, and nearly the same torque, 645 versus 650 pounds to foot. The thing is, although the Hellcat is both a Pirelli shareholder's best friend and a smoke machine, the Trackhawk, by virtue of all-wheel drive, puts all that screaming supercharged fury down to the pavement. The big Jeep also lurches back on its haunches in a fun but startling way. For a brief moment, it feels as if the Trackhawk's beak is pointed at the sun. The adaptive bill signs are actually fairly stiff, and would be stiffer still if I'd been in track mode, but with 70% of the power hitting the rear wheels, thanks to a fixed torque split, this Jeep is going to lean back when launching. How does this thing handle? Another reminiscence, if I may. Since I've driven the Porsche 918, I inevitably get asked how it is to drive. Fast, I say. It's just fast. Meaning, I know that I drove 4 laps around the big track at Willow Springs, but I literally remember nothing about the 889 horsepower hybrid Hypercar, save for how fast it is. Nada. Same is true for the Trackhawk, only in terms of initial acceleration. I know I took some corners in it, but the bulk of my memory comes from that first launch. It's just so brutally quick that I know I drove the Jeep aggressively on a curvy road, but I just can't get past the fury of leaving from a dead stop. Speaking of which, the Trackhawk hit 60 miles per hour in 3.3 seconds in our testing, beating Jeep's claimed time of 3.5 seconds. The quickest we've ever hit 60 miles per hour in Hellcat testing is 3.7 seconds. For both the Challenger and the Charger, both were 8-speed autos, we've never tested a manual. For SUVs, the quickest to 60 miles per hour we tested before the Trackhawk were Tesla Model X, 3.2 seconds, the Bentley Bentley, 3.5 seconds, the BMW X6 M, 3.7 seconds, and the Mercedes-AMG GLE 63 S Coupe 4MATIC, 3.9. Lamborghini is claiming 3.7 seconds to 60 miles per hour for the 650 horsepower Urus, though I think we'll see 3.4. Discounting the instant on torque of the Tesla, so far, so good for the Trackhawk. But right now is as good a time as any to mention one little caveat. We weighed the Trackhawk, and the results aren't pretty, 5,448 pounds. That's a lot of SUV. That AMG, for instance, which coincidentally shares the same underpinnings as the Trackhawk, the last remnants of Daimler Chrysler, weighs nearly 100 pounds less. 5,359 pounds. The X6 M comes in at a relatively trim 5,187 pounds. All of which makes the Trackhawk's acceleration that much more crazy. To continue that conversation, in the quarter-mile test, the Trackhawk runs 11.7 seconds at 116.2 miles per hour. Did you ever think we'd see the day when a production SUV runs the quarter in the 11s? That's just crazy. Or should I say ludicrous, as the Model X, when in ludicrous mode, also runs an 11.7 second quarter mile. However, the Trackhawk's trap speed is 0.2 miles per hour higher than the Model X's, so Jeep beats Tesla in a drag race. What a world. Speaking of 11s, the 600 horsepower Bentley runs 11.9 seconds at 117.1 miles per hour. Some other fast SUVs for you to consider, the X6 M. But that slowpoke took 12.1 seconds at 114.3 miles per hour. The quickest we've ever seen a four-door Hellcat run is 11.8 seconds at 124.3 miles per hour, meaning the Jeep is quicker, but the extra 900 pounds of lard and AWD hardware slows it down in terms of velocity, hence the 8 mile per hour gap at the end of 1,320 feet. The quickest two-door Hellcat ties the Trackhawk at 11.7 seconds. But its trap is higher still at 125.4 miles per hour. The Challenger Hellcat just happens to weigh 999 pounds less than the Trackhawk. That's 666 if you invert, coincidence or conspiracy? Just to further impress upon you how quick this Jeep is, the Corvette Grand Sport hits 60 miles per hour in 3.9 seconds and runs the quarter mile in 12.2 at 116.1 miles per hour. Moreover, the 650 horsepower Camaro ZL1 with the 10-speed auto hits 60 miles per hour in 3.5 seconds and runs the quarter mile in 11.5 seconds at 125.0. This Jeep is straight line legit. The Trackhawk's stopping power is neither great nor terrible, 108 feet from 60 miles per hour, not supercar distances but impressive given its ample heft. The figure 8 is another story. The time itself is solid, 24.7 seconds, which happens to tie the single Challenger Hellcat. We've tested three different Charger Hellcats and have seen 24.4, 24.5, and 24.6 seconds. Meaning this big Jeep can hustle. The experience, however, is more of a mixed bag. I just about put my foot through the floor on the first lap because the stopping power wasn't what I was expecting from the Brembos and P0s, road test editor Chris Walton said. Granted, it's a heavy mutha, and it goes across the middle of the course at 79 miles per hour, but I really had to back up the brake zone by about 3 Jeep lengths to make the corner of the skid pad. Once there, it turns in rather slowly, offers only a little hint of the front tire's punishment, and eventually settles into terminal understeer, he continued. The exit, however, is where the wee-ee-ee-ee happens. You can literally stand on the loud pedal and do a four-wheel drift until it's pointing straight. Then it simply goes like stink. Finally, all-wheel drive to make use of all that Hellcat horsepower and torque that can't be fully utilized in either the Challenger or Charger. I completely agree with Chris on that last point. I got bored of having to change tires on our long-term Hellcat. Simply put, the 707-horsepower Bark Lounger couldn't put its prodigious power to the ground. This supercharged Super Jeep sure can. Before the Trackhawk, if you would have told me that one day there will be a $100,000-plus Jeep, I would have assumed it would have been some sort of luxurious, reborn Grand Wagoneer, complete with the off-road chops the fabled brand is known for. I never would have seen a drag strip bruiser in the cards. Yet here we are. I'm sure we can all agree that there's no need for a vehicle like this. But boy, are we all happy Jeep gave it the green light. I got no problem with crazy, as long as it's the good kind of crazy. You know, the kind that makes a supercar-saturated car scribe giggle like a daughter. Ain't no underweighting here.